fell for that shit once. Fell in love and into a semi-long-term relationship with a man who kept on wanting to wait to have sex. He was hiding something!
My first movie, I actually booked this while working at Kaiser, was Knocked Up. That was directed by Judd Apatow with Seth Rogen. Thank you. First movie I ever did. And I shot that shit while still having my day job. I shot that during a vacation week because I'm a good fucking Asian, you know what I mean? I'm responsible. And it was the most creatively fulfilling experience of my life at that time because I got to work with everybody. Anybody who's anybody is in that movie, dude. You had Seth Rogen, Paul Rudd, Leslie Mann, Jonah Hill, Jason Segel, Martin Starr of Silicon Valley, Craig Robinson, Charlene Yee. You had like Bill Hader and Kristen Wiig. It was the Avengers of comedy. That's what that shit was. And I swear to God, my first time, I shot my last day of filming, it was such a dream. Judd Apatow said to me, he goes, "You're my discovery. You did such a great job. I'm gonna put you in all of my movies." And he did. So I would not be here if it wasn't for Judd. And then the next day I had to work at Kaiser. You know what I mean? I mean, that's how I came up with the Chow Jizz Toss, Kaiser. Toodaloo, hopes and dreams, you know? But like, can you imagine having a moment like that, doing a Judd Apatow film and going back to your day job, thinking that you're stuck? The next day, I could not stop thinking about that. I was like, well, maybe, I know I'm playing it safe, but maybe it's time for this college kid to turn pro, you know what I mean? Maybe I gotta fucking, I gotta rethink my life. Maybe this is the time for me to pursue acting full time, but, you know, look at me. I know I look like a fucking double-chinned Asian Mr. Burns with bad posture, but I don't know. I mean, maybe this is time for me. Maybe this is a sign. By the way, I'm thinking all this while 50 patients are waiting for me. Not a good look. And my nurse is desperately trying to get me to focus. She goes, "Dr. Jeong, you have a patient in room 2 waiting for you." I was like, "Well, nurse, you have a doctor who doesn't give a fuck." Just did a movie, Carol. Just did a movie, man. You don't get it. And believe it or not, I quit my day job the next day. True story. Oh, I was scared, man. I was fucking scared because I didn't have any family support. Like, my strict traditional Korean dad who wanted me to be a doctor before I was born, no, he was severely bumping on this shit, dude. He was just like, he cursing me out in Korean, you pinanum sekia, you bring great shame to Jeong family. And then after the hangover, "We are so proud. I knew you make it, boy. I knew you make it. I believe in you. We are so proud of your tiny ding-dong. So proud." "The smaller the penis, the bigger the box office." Oh, thanks, Papa. Great phrase. Okay. And yes, for those of you wondering, in The Hangover, yes, that was real in the trunk. I'm a grower, not a shower, all right? It was cold, I swear, all right? It was cold outside, all right? But I'm secure about it. It's how the pencil writes, bitch. It's how it writes. Mine can write in cursive. In cursive. Oh my God, calligraphy. Calligraphy. Konnichiwa, bitch. But I tell you, man, to be hangover rich and famous as an Asian kid, man, Asian parents, they don't know how to govern that, you know? My dad went from father to freeloader just like that, you know? Swear to God, as a kid, he was like, "You better get me good grades. After The Hangover, you better get me S-class Mercedes. Because E-class, that's for fucking farmers." Okay, Papa, good.
I do think this is a crux of a lot of our problems. I think you think your penis is more important to us than it is. It's important to you, and it should be, it's yours. But we do not care about it as much as you do. care about big dicks as much as men do. Men talk about big dicks a lot. It really seems to be on your mind. You're always saying stuff like, she needs a big dick. You should ask us. We're all different. I have a short torso. This is a finite amount of space. I think we should start thinking about penises and vaginas as a foot in a shoe situation. You ever try to jam your foot into a shoe that's two sizes too small? Imagine if the shoe had feelings. And you cared. And we should all know our size. At the end of a night at a bar, a guy should be like, I'm an 8, and you'd be like, well, I'm a 4, so no. Or a guy would be like, I'm a 2, and you'd be like, you should lie about that. Or show me a picture of your apartment. A 2 in a good apartment is a 6. That's just math. And we should talk about dicks and sizes. Sizes that we all know and understand. We have to stop talking about dicks and inches. Because I don't know how much an inch is. You know how I know a penis is too big? I see it and I go, oh no. No, you think I'm a different person. You think I'm old lung vagina. She needs a big dick. All right, what do you think I want out of sex? A hole in my back? To become a dolphin? Which vocally does make sense. Guys with big dicks. Sometimes I'll sort of move away and they'll be like, where are you going? And I'm like, to safety. You know, in boxing, if you punch someone in the liver, it's illegal. And yet, men still say, she needs a big dick. She needs you to text her back. And I'm sure there's some women in here whose preference is a big dick, and that's fine, to each their own. Me personally, more of a strong medium. Small is still not on the table. Small is, if you have a small penis, you should kill yourself. It's an honor killing, it's good. I feel like this is what Goldilocks was originally about. And then they were like, no, we're not gonna be able to read this to children. Even in Germany? Yeah. All right, porridge, but you get it.
A lot of people also seem to wonder, Ali, now that you have a daughter, are you gonna tone it down? Here's the thing, just because you became a parent doesn't mean you grew up.
Yeah. Bro-y dudes become bro-y dads. I'm the same piece of shit that I always was before I became a mom. Now just with more responsibility, and I'm barely rising to the occasion. And I'm not ashamed. I'm not gonna hide that I was very sexually active in my 20s. You know why? Because everybody knows the secret now, that when a woman sleeps with a man right away, it's not because we don't respect ourselves. It's because we don't respect you. As marriage material. That's why we let your dick inside so fast. By letting you in, we're really kicking you out of our future. Bye, Felicia. Be on your merry little way. We're just trying to have fun. We're not trying to trap your ass.
But you better be careful, because when a man When a man doesn't sleep with you right away, oh, it's not because he respects you. It's because he has a small dick. And he's trying to trap you. Do not fall for that trap. I'm gonna repeat that shit to my daughter over and over and over again. Do not fall for that trap. I fell for that shit once. Fell in love and into a semi-long-term relationship with a man who kept on wanting to wait to have sex. And I assumed it was because he thought I was so special and amazing and worth waiting for. He was hiding something! Months later, he finally agrees to get busy and unveils this tiny mess of a thing that wouldn't even reach your molars. It was a black dude. Creepy, right? Like seeing a homeless Asian person. What happened to you? It was a black dude, and I told all my black friends about it, and they were like, where the fuck is he at? We need to assassinate him right now before he further threatens to tarnish our sacred reputation. It was the first and last time I had ever seen an actual micropenis. And my honest first reaction when I saw it was, oh my God, are you okay? What happened? Did you just get hit by a bus? Did a car outside just like sideswipe your dick off? And now is your dick rolling around on the street like a severed snake head? And should we get a mason jar to scoop it up and bring you both to the hospital to have you sewn back together? Wait a minute. Is this some sort of Princess and the Frog test? Did a witch curse you a long time ago as punishment for calling her ugly? And now, if I put that in my mouth to prove that I love you, as a reward for my love, will it expand? Like one of those magic towels you pour water on.